James Elder for IFL TV in association with Matt Cleese, Jim Marbauer. We're in Dublin today for the first televised card from the MGM from Ireland. With me, I've got MGM's very own Sam Kinnock from the Scottish branch. What's happening, Sam?
Very well, thank you. Enjoying myself over here in Dublin.
Good. First and foremost, I want to just say congratulations on a great show from yourself in Scotland a couple of weeks back. Fantastic.
Thanks very much. Yeah, feedback's been excellent on the event. Planning's well underway for the next few events for the remainder of the year. So, yeah. Like I say, really good feedback. So, really happy with that, both from the boxers and the fans. Want to try and keep everybody happy as much as possible, and all the feedback's been along those lines.
I want to thank you as well for having us, our Cassie's Held a Show down at your gym and showing us about. It was a really good piece, and the Box Nation viewers really sort of got to know some of the fighters a little bit. I thought that was good.
Yeah, no, it's great. I mean, I think that's the beauty of boxing. Boxers are just normal guys, and to hear about their kind of their backgrounds, what they do for a living, what they do day to day, and what they like in the gym environment, I think it's really important just to see people under the bright lights on fight night. Sometimes isn't a true reflection of who that person is, so it's good to get a bit of the behind the scenes stuff like that. So thank you for coming up.
100%. You're here obviously shadowing the guys, I'm presuming, to kind of learn about the TV aspect of how they run a show. Would that be a fair statement?
That's entirely it. I mean, it's a totally different element of things, so I'm here just kind of in the background, helping out with everything that's going on, picking up the experience and just seeing what goes on. It's another dimension to an event, so obviously there's the whole event planning. When you put TV on, it adds another level of complication and everything else. I'm just here to pick things up, and with a view to getting the TV up to Scotland in the near future.
What's the one small but important fact you've learnt today while shadowing? Give me one fact. I'm putting you on the spot here, Sam.
One fact, I would just say the kind of importance of kind of planning and timing on things, because we came in today and there's a couple of things we just had to at the last minute move around, and it's just you just can't ever come to a venue to set up for anything too early. So this has been a press conference. Just the fact that we were here kind of 2.5 years in advance meant we could kind of get everything in place, because if we've been chasing our tail, we might have been still putting up this banner when people are walking in and things. You don't want that. So we managed to get here nice and early, and I'd say just the importance. That was a reiteration of something I already knew, but seeing the way the guys were operating, I sat up late with them last night planning things and getting over here today. So just that really kind of being punctual and arriving on time is important.
It's really exciting times for the MGM, obviously with the main core in Spain. You've then got all the fighters that they've been signing nationwide, plus then the Scottish branch. Now you've got the show's going on in Dublin, in Ireland, with that contingent. Real exciting times for the whole firm, isn't it?
Absolutely, it's all moving in the right direction. I think the real Celtic connection is so important as well. Developing the boxing in Ireland and in Scotland, and then have some crossover Irish boxers boxing in Scotland, vice versa, and then ultimately pairing them together. There's already a couple that we've kind of spoke about in passing. He's couple down the line, he's a couple down the line. What about when they're kind of 5, 6, 7, and 0? If they get that level, let's match them together, you know, and see what we can do, get the Celtic title in play and things. So that's it's really, really exciting. Just it's important. This TV platform is so important for all of the boxers. We want the same for Scotland, and just have it the same across the brand, really, so everybody's getting equal exposure. It's really important.
Will you be signing more fighters from the Scottish Isles? Is there any plans to bring more fighters in? What's going on?
Yeah, so we've had some meetings this week with some boxers. A lot of guys looking to come on board. If anything, for this next bill, we've got 10 contests already.
That's September?
That's the 5th of September in Meadowbank in Edinburgh. Provisionally sold out. All the tickets are with the boxers. There's been massive demand from the Edinburgh boxing public. So we've just signed 3 Scottish amateur champions from this year, all from the Loch Eyre Boxing Club. Lewis Benson, Stephen Tiffany and Tommy Philburn. And all 3 have got bright futures ahead of them. They'll be debuting on the September event. So we've got those guys just signed, other people looking to get signed, so it's just 100 miles an hour at the moment. But we're very mindful of the fact that we can't take on everybody, and those that we do take on, we need to be able to give them the time, get them the right fight, so we won't take people just for the sake of taking people.
I appreciate how busy you are and how sort of structured the gym is. There's people coming in, working and focused, so with that in take that in consideration, it makes it more embarrassing that my cousin hasn't turned up to your gym to use his free membership yet.
I don't know where he's been, James, to be honest. I've been in there waiting for him almost every day now, so
this is
fine. He needs to get himself down there for definite.
Now you see why we haven't got too many athletes in the family.
This is the
problem.
Exactly. Maybe you can just do our media. We'll get him a camera, get him up there. And then
if it's 6 30-second rounds, he's your man.
He's in for it, is he? Right, perfect. We'll bear that in mind then. That sounds good. We'll get him involved in the media side of things.
But listen, we're going to, again, try to be in Scotland for September. We're going to see how that pans out nearer the time. As you know, we are full of support for what you guys are doing. And keep doing what you're doing, Sam. Scotland really does, like you said, the Celtic Nations really does need that impetus and that push to put itself back on the map, you know?
Definitely. Well, like you say, we've got that show in September, then we're out in October, another big one in December, looking to sandwich one in the middle there as well. So keeping the boxes busy, keeping the event stream flowing, and trying to get the Scottish boxing public kind of active, and always looking to see they come to one event, we can then announce the next 2, 3, 4, so they can plan and schedule and become kind of real fans. Like, they kind of, I've alluded to it before, the UFC has that, people are just fans of the sport. Boxing's kind of lost its boxing public, and we're looking to just kind of reignite that and get people back involved and interested in boxing in Scotland, so hopefully we can achieve that.
You put on good fights, people watch good fights, they'll come back. It's that same old strategy, isn't it? It's kind of a thin line between trying to produce your talents and keep them winning as to putting them in good fights as well. People want a kind of a balance of the two, I think.
Exactly. With the first couple of events, it kind of has to be much more along the lines of guys making their debuts and things. Obviously, you're looking to get them the wins, but then after a couple of events, I mean, we've got a big event planned for December. There's going to be 50-50s on that for definite, and thereafter, every event's going to have some 50-50s. And it's a kind of, not an up or out policy, but it's kind of like guys have to just test themselves to see if they're going to progress, because what's the point in padding out a record indefinitely and then they lose? I mean, I feel there's a whole host of boxers out there, 16, 17, 18 and 0, but who have they actually boxed, what have they actually done? I don't think it's necessary, particularly with some of the guys who are just taking on board 100 plus amateur bouts. Why hang around? They obviously have to learn their trade, but we're not going to be kind of treading water forever. We want to move guys on and get meaningful fights in Scotland.
All right, Sam, well, exciting times ahead. I look forward to some further announcements, and we look forward to seeing some promotions for the September the 5th in Edinburgh.
Definitely.
Top man, Sam. I'll see you soon.
Thank you.